Do you have great ideas you want to share in a meeting, team building event, or maybe you want to motivate your team and try to win them over to your side? But there is just one snag. You are not sure how to approach the presentation. In this video, I will show you how you can come up with a good design that is balanced and visually appealing. You'll see how combining the right colors can make your presentation captivating. And I'll show you how to use shadow effect to add depth and make your presentation more realistic. Here is the presentation we are going to create by the end of this video. It's a simple, minimal design with the right color combinations and design element. The pentagon shapes, with each one slightly taller than the previous one, shows progress, and the gray and white backgrounds with the shadow create 3D effect, making the design look real. So grab your tea or coffee and let's get into it. Open PowerPoint. Let's start by changing the background color of the slide. Right click on the slide and select Format Background. In Format Background pane, ensure Solid Fill is selected. Go down and click on Fill Color. Under White Accent Colors, select the first color. It's 5% darker. Okay, background color done. Let's move to the next step by adding a title. Click on Insert tab, then on Text Box. Click anywhere on the slide and type Roadmap to Success. Let's format the title. Select the title, go to font and choose Monserrat font. If you don't have Monserrat font, there is a link to download the font in the video description. Or you can use Microsoft Yahoo UI or another font. Change its font size to 52 point. Let's make it bold. Click on bold or press Ctrl or Command plus B. Break the title into two lines and move it to the top left corner of the slide. Title sorted. Let's move to the next step by creating pentagon shapes. We need 6 pentagon shapes, one for each talking point. I'll move the shapes from slide 2 to slide 1. Let me show you how I created these pentagon shapes. From Insert tab, click on Shapes. Go to Block Arrows section and select Pentagon. Click and drag to draw a pentagon. Click on Rotate and select Rotate Left 90 degrees. In Shape Fill, choose No Fill. In Shape Outline, go to Weight and select 4.5 point. Go back to Shape Outline and select a color, or use eyedropper to select the first color from the color palette. There is a link in the description to download PowerPoint presentation containing color palettes, shapes, text, and icons used in this tutorial. Now you can duplicate the shape. Move it to the right. Increase its height and change its outline color. Repeat previous steps until you have all 6 shapes. Use different outline colors. Now it's time to add text to the shapes. If you have downloaded the presentation, let's move all the text in slide 2 over to slide 1. Click and drag over the text. Cut and paste on slide 1. Alternatively, you can go to Insert tab, click on Text box and type each text. One text box per text. Move all the text down, below the shapes. Go to font and select Monserrat. Set font size to 28 point. If you don't have Monserrat, use Microsoft Yahoo UI font. Let's rotate the text by 90 degrees so that they can stand vertically inside the pentagon shapes. In Home tab, click on Arrange. Go to Rotate and select Rotate Left 90 degrees. That's awesome. Let's place the text inside the shapes, one for each shape. Fantastic. Now we can move to the next step by grouping both the text and shapes together. Click and drag over each shape to select both objects. Press Ctrl or Command plus G to group them. Repeat previous steps for the rest of the shapes. Let's look at the sample slide to see where we have reached. We are on track. Let's add shadow effects to the slide. Go to Insert tab, click on Shapes and select Rectangle. Draw a rectangle to cover bottom lines of all the pentagons. Extend it to the bottom of the slide. Go to Shape Format tab, click on Shape Fill and select White Color. Let's remove its outline. Click on Outline and select No Outline. Let's make sure it covers the bottom of the shapes. In the next steps, we are going to apply shadow effects to the rectangle. Select the rectangle. If you don't see Format Shape pane, right-click on the rectangle and select Format Shape. In Format Shape pane, under Shape Options, select Effect and click on Shadow. Go to Color and choose Black. Set Transparency to 60%. Leave Size at 100%. Set Blur to 26 points. Angle to 167 degrees and distance to 3 points. When we look at the sample slide, only the top shadow is visible. To replicate that, we need another rectangle. From Insert tab, go to Shapes and select Rectangle. Draw a rectangle to cover the first one. It should have the same height, but the width should extend horizontally to both ends of the slide. Change its fill color to white and remove its outline. Let's make sure it covers the bottom shadow. The shadow creates a sense of depth, making it feel like you can literally touch it. That's fantastic. Let's continue with the next step. Before that, if you are enjoying this tutorial, I want you to like this video and subscribe to this channel so that you can get notifications when I post new videos. We are going to add icons to the design. On this sample slide, you can see the icons are placed in the circles. Let's create the first circle. From Insert tab, go to Shapes and click on Oval. Move your mouse under the first pentagon shape, hold down Shift key, click and drag to draw a small circle that fits the width of the pentagon shape. Let's remove its outline and change its fill color to the color of the first pentagon shape. Use eyedropper to pick the color. Duplicate the circle by pressing Ctrl or Command plus D. Move the duplicate under the second pentagon shape and change its fill color to the color of the second pentagon shape. Repeat these steps for remaining pentagon shapes. Now that all the circles are in position, let's place icons on them. Icons are available in downloadable file. Check video description for a link. Alternatively, you can use icons from PowerPoint's icons library. Go to Insert tab and click on Icons. Select the icons you want to use and click on Insert. Let's move the first icon to the first circle. In Graphics Format tab, change its graphics fill color to white. Repeat the previous steps and add 5 icons to the remaining circles. Now we are going to group the icons and circles together. Hold down Ctrl or Command and click on the first icon and first circle. Or you can click and drag your mouse over the circle to select both objects. Press Ctrl or Command plus G to group them. Let's repeat the same steps for the other 5 circles. Ladies and gentlemen, I think this presentation looks great.
Oftentimes, when presenting, we start with the first idea, then move to the next one, and so on. With flying animations, we can do that.
Go to Animations tab and click on Animation Pane. Select the title text. In Animations tab, select Fly In Animation. Click on Effect Options and choose From Top. In Animation Pane, right-click on the animation and choose Start with Previous. It means this animation will start with the slideshow. Double-click on the animation to open a dialog. Under Effects tab, set Bounce End to about 0.23 seconds and click OK. Increase its duration to 0.75 seconds. Click on the first pentagon, go to Animations tab and select Fly In Animation. Set its duration to 0.75 seconds. We'll leave its timing to start on click. Click on the first circle or icon and apply Fly In Animation. Make sure its effects option is from bottom. In Animation Pane, right-click on the animation, the third one, and choose Start with Previous. Leave its duration at 0.50 seconds and set delay to 0.25 seconds. With the first two animations done, we can copy and apply the same animations to the rest by using Animation Painter. Select the first pentagon shape. Click on Animation Painter. If you don't see it, click on Animation tab. Move the mouse to the second pentagon and click to apply the animation. Select the first circle or icon object. Click on Animation Painter. Move the mouse to the second circle or icon and click to apply the animation. In that same order, repeat the steps for the rest. Select Pentagon first, click on Animation Painter, then on the next pentagon. Then icon, Animation Painter, and the next icon. Let's run slideshow to see the results. Click slideshow icon on the bottom right of the screen. Ladies and gentlemen, this tutorial started with an idea. Then we created a plan and followed it up with execution. I showed you why this tutorial is important and I shared the business benefit it will bring to you. Finally, we worked as a team and now look what we've achieved together. Thank you for watching. I hope you have a wonderful day.